member of members of the awards committee in the Maine State Library Association. This has been a week of wonders. Last Thursday night, our daughter gave birth to a baby boy, our first grandchild. And now I'm here with all of you, receiving this extraordinary honor. It makes my head spin, and I wonder what's going to happen next week. I must say that I was astonished when Laurel called me. Although my husband and I moved to Maine 34 years ago, and although all 31 of my books were created on Peaks Island, my content, the content of books that I write and illustrate, is mostly global, not local, full of diverse children and cultures, many of which have only recently become part of the Maine community. So it's very moving to me to be claimed by the bestowing of this award as one of your own. All of my work is rooted in the pivotal childhood experience of moving from New England to South Korea, where my parents were hired to serve as medical missionaries. At age 7, I encountered a world strikingly different from the New Hampshire farmhouse and meadows of my early childhood. Not only was I immersed in a new language and new culture, but I witnessed the devastating impact of a war that had ended only 7 years before our arrival, including seeing children my age dressed in rags, rattling tin cans, begging for coins. My parents' dream was not to deliver relief or salvation to the poor Koreans, but instead to learn, to work, and to live with Koreans as colleagues, friends, and extended family. As a result, I came to know not just new words, but in myself and in my bones, new ways of looking at the world. And most of all, I learned in my heart that these different people were in fact my people, and I was theirs. I realized recently that what I've been trying to say in all of my work to all my readers is, look, here's your family. Our brand new grandson's name is Pei. Our daughter, who was adopted from Korea as a baby, chose it to honor her Korean heritage and his. When Taemin enters kindergarten in Sakha, Maine, in the fall of 2019, his class across the nation will be more than 50% children of color. Thank you for honoring work in which he and his classmates can see themselves, and for building the library collections that reflect the children of America. Thank you.